In the scripture, Nehemiah was living in a foreign country, working as a cupbearer for the king. He had an ordinary job. One day his brother came to visit him. He told how the walls of Jerusalem, their home city, had been torn down. Gates were burned, how the city was unprotected. The people were in danger. The scripture says, when Nehemiah heard this, he wept. He was heartbroken. For days he mourned. He asked God to do something. God put a dream in his heart to go back home and rebuild those walls. Well, that seemed impossible. He was living 1,000 miles away. He didn't have the funds, the materials, the crew, the experience. But God won't give you vision without provision. You may not see how, the odds are against you, but what you can't see is there are transfers coming. Things that you couldn't make happen, God will make happen. The king asked Nehemiah why he was so sad. He said, it's because our people are in danger. Our city is unprotected. The walls are down. The king could have said, too bad. It's not my problem. Don't bring your trouble to me. But the king said to Nehemiah, how can I help you? What's interesting is this king didn't worship Jehovah. He didn't believe in the God of Abraham, yet he's wanting to help Nehemiah. God will cause the right people to be good to you. Everyone that's going to help you accomplish your dream may not believe like you believe. They may not be living a godly life, yet they've been positioned in your path to help you move into your destiny. One of the main people that helped us acquire the Compact Center was the biggest partier. He loved to drink, to curse. He liked me, but he would make fun of the church. A colleague asked him to attend Lakewood with him. He said, no, I don't like going to the circus. He didn't offend me. I like the circus. My brother Paul's gonna come out in the high wire in a minute. I thought, you can make fun all you want as long as you keep using your influence to move us forward. He was the big reason that we got the building. You may be surprised at who God uses to fund your dreams, to open that door, to put in a good word for you. The king told Nehemiah that he could take time off and go back and rebuild the walls. Nehemiah was grateful, but he said, I don't have any materials. I don't have any funds to buy the wood, the stone, the rock, the mortar. The king said, that's no problem. I'll give you a letter requiring people to give you what you need. Nehemiah said, that's great, but it's dangerous traveling back home. I don't know if I'll make it there safely. The king said, don't worry. I'll let all the governors know that you're traveling through their city. They'll watch after you. Should have taken Nehemiah years, but he rebuilt the walls in just 52 days. How could this happen? This king who didn't worship Jehovah transferred his funds, his materials, his favor, his influence. God will put dreams in your heart that you can't accomplish on your own. Don't be intimidated. God is setting you up for a transfer. He's put the right people in your path. People that will use their influence to thrust you ahead. You may not have the experience, the funds, the connections, but God does. You're just one transfer away from seeing that dream come to pass. One transfer and you'll pay your house off. One transfer and your business will take off. I believe many of you are close to seeing this happen. You wouldn't be hearing this if there wasn't a transfer on the way. Now, don't talk yourself out of it. It'll never happen for me, Joel. I don't have the resources. I don't come from a prominent position. How could I do something great? You're right where Nehemiah was. He dared to believe. He dared to go to the king. He dared to pray bold prayers. Don't be intimidated by the size of your dream. God doesn't give big dreams to small people. There is greatness in you. There are new levels in you. There is a world changer in you. There is a history maker in you. That's why God put something big in you. He knows what you're capable of. Like with Nehemiah, he has people who will fund your dreams, people who will use their influence to open doors, people who will go out of their way to be good to you. I hope you enjoyed watching this clip. You can watch the full message here on our YouTube channel. We'd love to hear your prayer request. and how the ministry has impacted your life, you can leave a comment below. Make sure to subscribe to our channel to stay inspired all throughout the week. We'll see you next time.